guest, most revered president of today's meeting, Srimad Swami Gautamanandaji Maharaj, to deliver the presidential address.
Om Sthapakaya Cha Dharmasya Sarva Dharma Swarupine Avatar Varishthaya Ramakrishnaya Te Namaha Namaste Yati Rajaya Vivekananda Suraye Satchit Sukha Swarupaya Swamine Tapaharine. My dear Swami Suviranandaji, Swami Suparnanandaji, Swami Bhalabhadranandaji, Justice Ashok Kumar Ganguliji, Justice Vishwanath Samadharji, and my very dear devotees and friends of Sri Ramakrishna, Sharda Devi, and Swami Vivekananda. You have been hearing three wonderful speeches, one by Swami Suviranandaji in his welcome address, and just now Swami Balabhadranandaji, and a very nice paper of Pranab Mukherjee, the ex-president of India, was also very interesting. And so now I will present a few of my feelings about this relevance of Swami Vivekananda's Chicago addresses. When I see this big audience, I remember in the life of Swami Vivekananda, in the West when he was in America, he used to announce to some of his devotees, "You come to my speech, I will throw bombs there, you will see my throwing bombs." And the author writes, he really did throw bombs of spiritual nature. To get those bombs burst upon them, people came and came. In big halls could not suffice. So people had to be stopped from coming. When I see this big audience, there are also people saying outside they could not get to it. I am reminded of the tremendous influence of Swamiji's words. Whenever I hear the September 11 of 1893, at the date of Swami Vivekananda's lectures, which were historic and joyful in nature at the Parliament of Religions at Chicago, I am strangely reminded of another tragic September of 2001, which you all know, when some extreme religious fanatics demolished the world's highest World Trade Center building at New York by a suicide plane attack. You all know this. This latter, that is the 2001 September 11, date is remembered by the American embassies all over annually. They organize a memorial day to discuss this event, the cause and how to avoid such future occurrences. I was a speaker at Chennai in the first year memorial day held in 2002, held at American Embassy there. And the American Consul General was one Dr. Haynes. I told in the meeting that there was another September 11 of 1893, which should be remembered also in the American history. That is the day Swami Vivekananda spoke in Chicago, Parliament of Religions, held in September 1893, and he mainly stressed on the need for a universal brotherhood based on the eternal spiritual nature of man and of nature. Swami Vivekananda spoke then about man's being divine, and to love and serve man was equal to the service of God, to the worship of God. If the divinity of man and the way to manifest it were taught as Swamiji advised then to the people, then universal brotherhood would have become a reality now, cutting across all barriers of race, religion and nationality. Every intellectual in this world now knows about the great message of the unity of mankind given by Swami Vivekananda in the Parliament of Religions. In that August assembly, Swami Vivekananda started with the historic opening verse, which you all know, Sisters and Brothers of America.
Swami Vivekananda.
Sisters and Brothers of America. It fills my heart with joy unspeakable to rise in response to the warm and cordial welcome which you have given us. I thank you in the name of the most ancient order of monks in the world. I thank you in the name of the mother of religions. And I thank you in the name of the millions and millions of Hindu people of all classes and sects.
Which raised an instant applause of 7,000 elite world audience. He spoke about the spiritual brotherhood and sisterhood of humanity because we, men and women, irrespective of our color or country, race or religion, are children of one God. Then the question arises, what prevents us from feeling this unity? Swami Vivekananda said, it was a religious sectarianism, religious bigotry, religious fanaticism. He spoke about how we should learn about other religions also and assimilate the good points of others, and then alone can we evolve a universal religion of love and cooperation acceptable to all humanity. Swami Vivekananda said that the future religion of the intellectuals in the world would be such a religion in which every religious person would help members of other religions to progress in spiritual and secular life also in their own way, in their own methods, would assimilate what is good in other religions and become a liberal person. He would embrace all good people and try to do everything to encourage peace and harmony among the followers of various religions and cultures of the world. Historians record, we all know now, that the general audience of Parliament of Religions of Chicago welcomed heartily Swami Vivekananda's words of universal brotherhood and universal religion. Swami Vivekananda became instantly, he was accepted as the greatest among the delegates of the Parliament of Religions. He was even hailed as a divine orator. Some wise ones in that assembly said at that time that instead of sending the foreign missionaries to India, which had produced a prophet like Vivekananda, India should send missionaries to our countries. Current to the West regarding India and her people's whole religion and culture called Sanatana Dharma or eternal religion, from hatred and apathy to appreciation and love. Thus, many centers to preach Vedanta, the universal religion of the Vedas, as taught by Swami Vivekananda, sprang up in USA and in Europe even during his time. Swami Vivekananda himself admitted that he had sown the seeds of Vedanta in the Western world among a few thousands, and that he expected them to sprout in the near future. Today, we have nearly 40 Vedanta centers in the West and nearly 200 centers all over India and in the Southeast. There is a growing demand for Indian Vedanta centers everywhere. The other day we opened a center at Philippines, another at Dublin in Ireland, another at Zambia in Lusaka in East Africa. All this indicates the tremendous power of Swamiji and how it's attracting people to its fold. Further, the organizing committee consisted of Mr. Burroughs, Cardinal Gibbons, etc., that which organized the 1893 Parliament of Religions successfully in Chicago, is yet existing and continuing the organizing of similar parliaments of religions in the intervals of 3 or 4 years in different parts of the world. They also hold a mini pre-parliament of religions in India at that time when they organize it in other parts of the world. Why do they organize it in India? It is just to remember the message of the lasting harmony and peace to the world given by the great Swami Vivekananda, who was born in India. They feel that that message has greater relevance to the world today than what it had then in 1893. Again, we all know how the religious fanaticism destroyed the World Trade Center, which I referred in September 11, 2001, and has given a violent jolt to the socio-religious thinking of the Western and the Eastern world. Now all Western and Eastern countries, and they all want urgently freedom from religious fanaticism so that humanity can live in peace. We can clearly see that Swami Vivekananda's way is the only way to achieve that. Hence we see this worldwide celebration of Vivekananda's message given at the Parliament of Religion at Chicago in 1893 September. All over the world they are celebrating these addresses of Swamiji. Now coming to India, we, the followers of Swami Vivekananda, in each 29 states of Indian Federation are celebrating the same by taking Vivekananda's message to the common people of our country. During the 125th year celebration of Swami Vivekananda's Chicago addresses in 2018, in Tamil Nadu alone, where I am there, the Ramakrishna Mutt Chennai has organized various youth functions like essay writing, painting and speaking competitions among 12.5 lakhs of college students, and from whom 20,000 art pieces were received, more than 2 lakhs essays, poems, etc. about Swamiji's speeches were received. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi himself addressed the concluding youth conference of 4,000 youth held on September 11, 2018 at Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. See the tremendous influence of Swamiji's addresses. Dear friends, I want to conclude by giving a short idea of what Swami Vivekananda spoke at the Parliament of Religions in 1893, more than a century ago. His first lecture was on September 11, as you all know, famous for his opening words, "Sisters and Brothers of America." He thanked the world in that lecture of 7,000 audience, selected audience, in the name of India's most ancient order of monks, in the name of India's eternal religion, which he called the mother of religions, and then in the name of millions and millions of Hindus of all classes and sects. He said that Hinduism not only tolerated but accepted all religions as truth. He prayed that all fanaticism, either through sword or pen, should disappear to save our world from repeated violence and bloodshed. In his second lecture on 15th September 1893, he talked on why we disagree. He spoke about religious sectarianism, which he compared to the mentality of a frog in the well, which thought that his well was all that was in the universe. In the third lecture on 19th September, titled "Paper on Hinduism," was a marvelous presentation of Hinduism as based on the truth of spiritual realizations of sages of the Vedas. He said that because it was based on the undeniable human experience of the truths of every religion, namely God, soul and creation, it has stood the test of time, of thousands of years of criticisms and persecution by materialists, by atheists, by agnostics, etc., etc. It has proved itself as rational as any of the material sciences are. He concluded that Hinduism, called more correctly as Vedanta, can stand the scrutiny of the most recent discoveries of science and thus had no fear of reason. In his fourth lecture of 20th December, titled "Religion is Not the Crying Need of India," he said that to preach religion to a starving people is futile. Don't give stones where people need bread, he said. It was the hero's admonition to the wrongdoings of foreign missionaries in India, who did not help victims of famine but erected churches instead. In his fifth lecture on September 26th, titled "Buddhism, Fulfillment of Hinduism," he said that Vedanta proclaimed that God alone lives in every being. Buddha applied this to practical life and advised the uplifting of all the lowly and the neglected people, including women, by selfless service and by imparting high morality to them with love and compassion. Thus, the teachings of Buddha were supplementary and never contradictory to the tenets of Hinduism. His last and sixth lecture on 27th September was a master speech where he argued for a universal religion which would be a happy synthesis of the noble teachings of all religions minus their sectarianism. He prophesied more than 25 years back that all religions would be compelled by social forces in the very near future to accept the principles of a harmony of religions, and said, "Soon will be written on the banner of every religion, help and not fight, assimilation and not destruction, and harmony and peace and not dissension." Today, we are seeing his ideas being worked out through so many world organizations like United Nations Organization, Interfaith Dialogues by various religionists, International Peace Prizes, etc., etc. May Swami Vivekananda's message bring lasting peace to our world. Let us pray to Swami Vivekananda to inspire and guide us all to work hard to attain this goal in our own humble way, that is, through leading a life of love, compassion, charity, and selfless service to our fellow men. Thank you all for your patient hearing and encouragement. Jai Vivekananda. Om Shanti.
We have just heard the presidential address. Our most respectful pranam to Revered Maharaj Ji.